I'm here with Pilar Wolfsteller from A-Cubed. What is A-Cubed exactly?
So A-Cubed is the Silicon Valley outpost of the aircraft manufacturer Airbus.
Okay, very cool. And again, I think most people only know of Airbus as a bunch of A320s and A380s and stuff like that. So what is A-Cubed up to, and why is Airbus involved with this?
So A-Cubed is a wholly owned subsidiary of Airbus. We are basically the, you know, a research and technology shop based in Silicon Valley in San Jose in order to drive innovation within the company. So we are here to invent cool things that have to do with aviation that could someday find themselves in an Airbus product.
So which one are you most excited about? What can you talk about?
Which one of the projects?
Yeah.
So I am most excited about Vahana, which is our self-flying autonomous air taxi that we are building a prototype right now, and we hope to fly it by the end of the year, and we're looking for a demonstrator by the year 2020. So we're hoping that in maybe 10 years' time, all of us will be flying around in these air taxis rather than sitting in traffic on the ground in a car.
So culturally, it sounds like it's a pretty different culture from traditional Airbus. Is that accurate?
Absolutely. It's a very, very Silicon Valley culture. I mean, we move fast. We take on projects at very high risk, very, very strong, short timelines. So we're really in the whole Silicon Valley mindset of trying to create new technology in a very short space of time and then making it fly.
Very cool. And so your background, what did you do before this? How did you get into this? Why A-Cubed for you?
So I was a journalist for a very long time. I spent many years in Europe working as a journalist, and I moved over to corporate communications about 10 years ago. And I myself am a private pilot, and I have been fascinated with the miracle of flight since I was 6 years old. So about a couple of months ago, when A-Cubed was looking for someone to lead their communications department, I just thought, I am the perfect person. I'm the only person on earth that could do this job. I have a background in Europe. I have a couple of European languages. I have an absolute passion and fascination for flight. And and my journalism background, I think, is really helping in this role as well.
So we're going to get in the weeds for a second. When you sat in for the interview, did you know you were getting the job?
I didn't. I was so scared that they would take someone else.
Yeah. How long was it after your interview until you knew for sure you had nailed it?
It took about 3 weeks.
Okay.
Yeah, I was not sleeping for about 3 weeks.
So were you on a different path at the time? Like when this job came up, were you active in another job, or were you just hanging out at the time?
So I was working in technology and communications in the tech sector in Silicon Valley. I was working for IT services company at the time.
Okay. So
I did
have a big shift.
It is a big shift, but I've finally been able to merge my passion with my career, and I think that is the dream of every single person, is when you can take your skills and do something useful with it and love every minute of what you're doing with it.
Okay, so 10 years down the road, we're standing here talking about what Airbus is up to. And again, it seems like Airbus is playing in the future. So I'm really curious, what is our conversation going to be like then?
So I think Airbus really is playing in the future. And the motto is, we make it fly. And in 10 years, we'll be flying very, very different vehicles than we are today. So we'll be talking about the next generation Vahana, which could be for perhaps 4 or 8 people. We'll also be talking about perhaps a new airspace management system, air traffic management system, because right now with all the drones and with the commercial aircraft and now with things like Vahana coming into play, I think that whole space has to be completely reconceived. So that's something that we're looking at right now as well. Perhaps we'll be flying in commercial aircraft that look very different than they do today. Perhaps we'll be flying in modular aircraft. So I think there's a whole range of, you know, inventions that we haven't even thought of yet that between now and 10 years from now, you know, could be actually real.
That's fantastic. Well, thank you so much for the info. We're really excited to see what comes next. And I mean, I think everyone is excited for our Jetsons future, and it sounds like Airbus and A-Cubed are going to be a big part of that.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thanks for checking out the video, and thanks to Aviation Week. Make sure to go to aviationweek.com/Oshkosh, where you could sign up for all the highlights and updates of what's going on here at Oshkosh. Also, please go check out our channel Take Off with Nick and subscribe for updates. Thanks a lot.